Two Ways to View Our Diets with a Biblical Perspective, written by Jennifer Waddle and read by Kelly Givens. Today's Bible verse is Genesis 1:29. And God said, "See, I have given you every herb that yields seed, which is on the face of all the earth, and every tree whose fruit yields seed, for to you it shall be food." Thousands upon thousands of searches for the word diet are Googled each month. And every new year, resolutions are made to go on a diet and lose excess weight. It may be surprising to some, but the Bible actually has a diet plan as well. God instituted it in Genesis chapter 1 and then expanded it in Genesis chapter 9. Genesis 1:29 tells us that every herb that yields seed, which is on the face of all the earth, and every tree whose fruit yields seed, to you it shall be for food. And then Genesis 9:3 goes on to say, "Every moving thing that lives shall be food for you. I have given you all things, even as the green herbs." Some would argue that the original plan of a plant-based diet is best, while others would insist that eating meat is essential for good health. But no matter what our personal preferences are, God never intended for us to take food to the extremes that we have. Food is simply nourishment for our bodies so that we can carry out the work of the Lord. It was designed to be enjoyed and savored by the taste buds God created. We, however, have become so focused on the particulars of our diet that we've lost perspective. So here are two ways we can view our diets from a biblical perspective. First, choose wisely and move on. Jehovah Jireh, our provider, supplies the sustenance our bodies need. Jesus told his followers not to worry about what they would eat or drink. In that day, it was more about having enough food to eat. Today, even though most of us have food in abundance, we still worry far too much about food. We can still make wise choices about our diets without the hyper-focus and worry. As Matthew 6:26 tells us, "Look at the birds of the air, for they neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they?" We are valuable to God. He provides for us because he loves us. Our worries about food are fruitless. We can and should make wise choices, choices that will fuel our bodies for the work God has purposed in us. But then we should move on to the more important things in life. And secondly, trust God and enjoy the food he has made. Unfortunately, the diet industry has hindered our enjoyment of food. The nagging guilt that follows every piece of birthday cake and the time-consuming reading of every package has knocked the joy right out of eating. However, if we simplify our diet and eat the food that God made, all the guesswork is eliminated. It's okay to search for the best quality of foods, but in the end, it all comes down to trust. Do we trust God or the promises on the food label? With thankfulness, we can receive our portion, the portion God so lovingly provides. We can trust him to strengthen us and bring enjoyment of his provision. And we can have a biblical perspective of our diets that will free us to do exactly what he has created us to do.
Hey everyone, thanks for listening to Your Daily Bible Verse, a production of the Salem Web Network. If you enjoyed what you heard today, we'd love for you to head over to iTunes and rate and review our podcast. It really does help people find us. This episode was produced by our managing editor, Kelly Givens, and recorded and edited by Stephen Sanders. Be sure to come back tomorrow as we examine more of God's Word.